So, you know, along the same vein, you know, with the numbers, North Royalton Schools will gain about $1.1 million mm-hmm. in state funding over the next 2 years. Many neighboring school districts, including Strongsville mm-hmm. and Rexville, mm-hmm. Broadview Heights, lost money. Mm-hmm. I wanted to ask you about your opinion about the redistribution of state funds. Do you believe it was fair? And then how does North Royalton plan to spend the extra money?
I'm sure they're going to be. First of all, I'm sure the extra money is going to be looked at for building repairs. We are in dire need of building repairs. As for fairness, I will say, and I've done a lot of walking with and talking to people in the community, and not relative to this, but I will say when we do talk, people recognize that Strongsville has a lot of industry and a lot of tax base coming from that. So does Brecksville and several other neighboring communities. North Royalton isn't really the same. Our funds come from property taxes and whatever levies or bonds that they're putting on. We just don't have that industrial tax base like others. So I'm comfortable that we were able to get those funds into our district.
Absolutely. Well, I know you mentioned building repairs. Mm-hmm. What buildings need work, and how does the district plan to get that done?
Well, they have a community engagement task force that they've put together to bring common people in. However, it has a lot of former teachers, and there's an administrator on there, and then it has a group that are residents. And they're trying to bring them together and discuss the needs and go in a direction to repair the buildings. I will tell you, they've got to get the roofs fixed. I know we've done some, and I did do some investigating on this. So what I found out is roofs replaced in 1987 and 1994 by capital bonds, they're deteriorating, and it was due to a poor material selection. And the reason is they should have put asphalt and roofing paper on there, but they did single ply membranes. And single ply membranes only last 15 to 20 years.
And where, what buildings are we talking about?
Oh, you're talking the high school, Albion. They talk about the middle school. So even the middle school, they did the same thing. In 1995, the middle school was built and it's needing repair. And these single ply membranes only last 15 to 20 years. So now we've got a lot of schools having difficulties, and we only have a 1 million PI. And the 1 million.
And explain to people what a PI is.
Oh, 1 million permanent improvement. And you voted on this. The permanent improvement came in, I think it was in the late 2000s or around there. And what it is we automatically get 1 million every year from the taxes. To go for needs of the buildings and that. However, as in the 2014 report, 500,000 of that money went to buses, purchasing buses. 200,000 of that went to interest and fiscal charges for the stadium replacement. So when we went ahead and built that stadium, they didn't have enough funds. They went and got these certificate of participation bonds. And those bonds have to be paid off. So we take $200,000 out of the permanent improvement, which was designated for buildings every year.
Was this this year?
No, I was not on the board at the time that happened.
So basically what you're saying is they didn't put the money that they needed to in the roofing in the past.
Right.
And the school district right now is having to
difficulties because now we're short and they really have to figure out how to work within their budget because the last four bonds have not passed.
So how do you, you know, you mentioned that the last four bonds haven't passed.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you've got to get those kids to have a roof over their head.
They do.
Right.
And we did sell property off of Edgerton, and we had some other funds, and they did satisfy the needs in the high school and at Albion, which was the worst.
So how do you hope to rectify the situation?
maybe they need to cut 10% across the board and put some of that money into the repairs.
Well, I know that you mentioned that a possible solution that you would have is cut
10% across the board and start fixing what we need in the buildings. If the bonds are not going to pass and people are, I mean, that's if they're not going to pass. The other thing was, is when the last one went on, it was like $28 million or something. And don't quote, I mean, I'm, I know I'm saying this on TV, but I don't have that in front of me. And I know they wanted to do a permanent improvement. But when you combined it for the total amount, it surpassed 50. And I don't have all those numbers in front of me. But I think if they were either to do a $1 million permanent improvement to add to the other one, or see if the public would accept a $25 million to get our needs and prioritize what we need. That's the other thing. You have to really prioritize. And even if you're putting a roof on, say, the middle school, you go, A, this is what it would be if we had no tear-offs, none of this, none of these other issues. B, if we had certain issues, this would what would it be? And C, at the extreme, this would, you know. So you prioritize exactly what the costs are, so you have that to supply to the public.
Right. So some of the options that you're suggesting, and none of these would, you know, be, you do them all, or, you know, you do one of them, you know, they're options, and obviously they're not on the table right now, but some of the options that you're suggesting are an additional permanent improvement tax.
Just that one.
Or a $25 million bond.
Right, individually.
Right. Or cutting
10% across the board.
Right. So those are, you know, and you would obviously just pick one, but those are options that you believe the board needs to consider.
We need to look at some avenue because we're kind of, we're not moving forward on some of this. I mean, we did put this community engagement task force together to come back with information, and hopefully they're talking to residents like I have been talking to residents.